بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا وهدى وتقى ورشادا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم فقهنا في الدين وعلمنا التأويل. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن نفس لا تشبع ومن دعوة لا يستجاب لها. نعوذ بك اللهم من هؤلاء الأربع. أما بعد، فحياكم الله جميعا في درس من دروس تفسير سورة البقرة. نبدأ بسم الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول، He says: وقلنا يا آدم اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة فكلا، أو وكلا، هنا وكلا إن أعرف فكلا، وكلا منها رغدا حيث شئتما ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة فتكونا من الظالمين. طيب، نبدأ الآن. الله سبحانه وتعالى what is the ayah that was mentioned before this one? What is the ayah that, or what is the story that is mentioned before the story of telling Adam alayhi salam to live in the Jannah? What is the qissah that is mentioned before this? We have a look in Surah Al-Baqarah, any quickly. The qissa before it, ya ikhwan, is the creation of Adam alayhi salam, is the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him a khalifa on this earth. It is the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him the names of all things, allama Adam al-asma'a kullaha. Then and the story of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking the angels to prostrate to Adam alayhi salam. What is common in all of these three things? Khalifa, علم آدم الأسماء كلها وإذ قلنا للملائكة اسجدوا لآدم. What is common in all these three things? Giving فضيلة to Adam, يعني إكرام لآدم عليه السلام, honoring آدم عليه السلام. What is common in all these three different stories is that there is honor for Adam alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored Adam alayhi salam. Now keep this in mind for a question that will be asked later on, that this siyaq, this context is in the ikram and honor of Adam alayhi salam. Tayyib. Just keep this in mind for a question that will be asked later on. Tayyib. Now let's go get into the ayah. وَقُلْنَا يَا آدَمُ اسْكُنْ أَنْتَ وَزَوْجُكَ الْجَنَّةِ. And we said, يَا آدَمُ, O Adam, اسْكُنْ أَنْتَ وَزَوْجُكَ الْجَنَّةَ. What is the meaning of اسْكُنْ? This is sahl, this is very easy. What is the meaning of اسْكُنْ, يَا إِخْوَان?
Live.
أحسنت, يعني live in, يعني in the Jannah. طيب, why was أنتَ, يعني, يعني mentioned here, يعني the فعل أمر, the فاعل of فعل أمر is always ضمير مستتر. The فاعل, not always, but in this case for مفرد, the فاعل here is ضمير مستتر. تقديره أنت, يعني it's inside, أسكن, it's hidden, أنت, أسكن أنت, it's hidden inside, the فاعل. This أنت here, it is not the فاعل. It is called ضمير فصل. Why has this ضمير been repeated? Or why is there a need to mention this ضمير?
To emphasize Allah's bounty upon him.
لا, هنا ليس للتأكيد. Here it's not for تأكيد. That's what I wanted to say. When you want to make an عطف, يعني you want to mention another addressee, another فاعل for فعل أمر or for any فعل, then what do you have to do? Sometimes you have to, after the فعل, you must repeat the ضمير. مثلا, if I say, يعني, if I want to say that Ahmed sat and so did Zayd. طيب, So I would say Ahmed. مثلا we're talking about Ahmed. طيب. So I wouldn't say قاعدة وزيد. I wouldn't say قاعدة وزيد. قاعدة means to sit. I wouldn't say قاعدة وزيد. Rather I would have to say قاعدة. قاعدة هو وزيد. طيب. So you have to repeat the ضمير or you have to mention the ضمير فصل in order to be able to يعني make an عطف for another word or another noun upon this. يعني أنت إذا أردت أن تعطف كلمة أخرى أو اسما آخر على الفاعل فلا بد أن تذكر الضمير. You have to mention the ضمير if you want to mention another فاعل, another doer after حرف عطف. So this is why أنت here is repeated. Or أنت here is needed to be mentioned. This is ضمير فصل. This is not the فاعل. This is not the فاعل. هذا is the ضمير فصل. طيب. أسكن أنت وزوجك. ليش ما قيل؟ لماذا لم يقل زوجتك؟ Why did it not say وزوجتك؟ Why did it not say زوجتك؟ نعم. Don't. طيب don't. لا بس. See. يعني in Arabic هناك لغات يعني there are different variations. It's not necessary in order to refer to the wife. It's not necessary that you use the word زوجة. Rather زوج itself is enough. Okay, you can say زوجك, you can say زوجتك. Both are correct. Both are correct. And how will we, distinguish? يعني when it is intended? يعني when is the wife intended and when is the husband intended? By the سياق, by the context. If the سياق does not help you determine whether the one intended is the husband or the wife, then you must use زوجة. Then you must use زوجة. If the سياق, if the context does not help you determine that, then you must use زوجة in order to make it easy for the listener to distinguish and differentiate between the husband and the wife. Else, it's absolutely, it's equally fine to use زوج and زوجة. Some of the scholars of نحو, they have said that زوج is more فصيح. زوج, to يعني, use زوج for wife, that's the أصل, and زوجة would be used for, يعني, for a need. So that's why زوج has been, using زوج is absolutely the same as زوجة. طيب, now is the, يعني, more important question. If you notice in the Quran, observe in the Quran, يعني, many times the wife is referred to as امرأة فلان. وقالت امرأة فرعون مثلا. طيب, or وقالت امرأة عمران. أو امرأة فرعون يعني امرأة نوح وضرب الله مثلا للذين كفروا امرأة نوح وامرأة لوط. So the wives are referred to as امرأة فلان, the woman of فلان. And sometimes the wives are referred to as زوج, like it is here, وزوجك الجنة. What is the difference between زوجك and امرأتك? زوجك and امرأتك. Why زوجك here and when it comes to فرعون or نوح عليه السلام or it was about لوط عليه السلام, it was described as امرأتك.
Compatibility, perhaps.
Sorry?
Compatibility.
Compatibility. In what terms?
I think in every aspect, when both spouses are compatible in terms of their religion and compatible completely for each.
طيب أنت سمعت هذه الفائدة من قبل أم أنت أتيت بها الآن؟
كأنني سمعت من قبل.
ما شاء الله تبارك الله. طيب من من سمعتها؟
أظن نعمان.
ما شاء الله تبارك الله, الله يوفقك. ما شاء الله. طيب ممتاز. He says that زوج, what is the meaning of زوج in linguistically? يعني, what does زوج mean?
Wife.
لا صحيح, but like pair, pair no. exactly pair.
Pair, yeah.
مثيل, pair, يعني أزواج وآخر من شكله أزواج, يعني similar things, things that are similar. زوج refers to things that are similar. يعني مثلا فاسلك فيها من كل زوجين اثنين. نوح عليه السلام is being told to carry with him two of every type of animal, right? Two similar, يعني زوجين, يعني two similar animals. طيب زوجين اثنين. So زوج refers to something that is similar to the other, which is why زوج is used in for a wife that has the same religion as her husband. زوج is used for a wife that has the same religion as her husband. So when it's زوجك الجنة, يعني this is زوجك آدم عليه السلام and حواء عليه السلام, they have the same religion. But when it comes to امرأة فرعون, امرأة فرعون مسلمة وفرعون كافر, وامرأة نوح كافرة, ونوح عليه السلام نبي من أولي العزم من الرسل. امرأة لوط, امرأة لوط كافرة, ولوط عليه السلام مسلم نبي صالح. All right. Okay, but then remains one, there remains one issue here. Then why was it said, وقالت امرأة عمران؟ And why did زكريا say, وامرأتي عاقر؟ He didn't say, وزوجي عاقر. زكريا عليه السلام, when he was beseeching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking him for a child, he said, وامرأتي عاقر. My wife is barren. My woman is barren. وامرأتي. And here, وقالت امرأة عمران.
There wasn't a compatibility because she was childless.
Compatibility. And, the compatibility now, it doesn't go here. But the childless point, that's true. That's no. true. That is because there was a need to highlight the fact that they are that she is a woman. There was a need to highlight the fact that she was a woman and she was childless. طيب ومرأتي عاقر. كذلك when it was said with regards to Ibrahim عليه السلام, فأقبلت امرأته في صرة فسكت وجهها فسكت وجهها. So because they were childless, so their characteristic of being a woman was highlighted. Wallahu a'lam. Wallahu a'lam. طيب نأتي الآن إلى وزوجك الجنة. ما المراد بالجنة؟ What is intended here by الجنة? Which جنة? Is this the جنة where we are going to live forever, inshallah? Or is this some other جنة? Hi, شباب.
It seems it's the Jannah that is known to us, perhaps because of the Alif and Lam.
Alif, because of the Alif and Lam, it's the real, it's the Jannah, يعني which in which inshallah we'll be living forever because of the Alif and Lam. Alif and Lam is this al التعريفية. Al is al ahdiya, al ahd al ذهني. يعني al ahdiya, يعني the one that we all know, the one that we all know. Like for example, if I say to you, I'm going to Al-Madina. أنا ذاهب إلى المدينة. Which city will you understand from this? أنا ذاهب إلى المدينة. المدينة النبوية. المدينة النبوية, right? Why? Because Al-Madina, يعني the one that we all know. Likewise, الجنة. الجنة. This Al, يعني the one that we all know. طيب. وكلا منها رغدا حيث شئتما. وكلا منها رغدا حيث شئتما. طيب what is the use of واو here, يعني instead of فا وكلا منها, instead of saying فكلا منها, يعني or let's just ignore فكلا منها, just say what is the usage or what do you benefit from the واو here, وكلا منها. طبعا مصطفى انت لا تتكلم لاني كتبت الفائده بالعربيه, فكف عن الكلام لهذا السؤال. وكلا منها. هيا شباب. وقلنا يا آدم اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة وكلا منها. It gives meaning of مع with أحسنتم. It gives meaning of sort of with. يعني this is this goes together with your residence in the Jannah. يعني as you stay in the Jannah, as long as you stay, you eat from the fruits of Jannah وكلا منها. يعني اسكن وكل. اسكن أنت يعني اسكنا وكلا. As long as you're living here, you're eating and benefiting from the Jannah. وكلا منها رغدا. طيب, if you notice the ayah in Surah Al-A'raf, it says فكلا منها. Go to ayah 19 from Surah Al-A'raf and you'll notice فكلا منها. What is the difference between وكلا and فكلا? And why is there a difference between the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah and the ayah in Surah Al-A'raf? Think about it.
Can you repeat the question?
Yeah, the question is, أخي, الله يبارك فيك. Why did it say in أعراف فكلا with a فا, and here وكلا? In Al-A'raf, it says فَكُلَا. Ayah 19 in Surah Al-A'raf, it says فَكُلَا. Here it says وَكُلَا. Is the فَا in the other ayah فَا السَّبَبُ? Yeah, لَيْسَ فَا السَّبَبُ. يعني, even if it is, like, why فَا السَّبَبِيَة? يعني, there and not here. طبعا, فَا means so, or after. يعني, it gives you the sense that, يعني, after this, you do the other thing. يعني, مثلا, I will... أتم الصف الأول فالأول فالأول يعني first fill the first صف then the next first يعني it gives you the meaning of then as well. يعني it's just similar to ثم, but واو is not like فا. واو means like together at the same time.
It seems to me that the two verses complement each other from the perspective that in Araf Allah is telling them to leave and then the instruction comes to eat, to that it is permissible for them to eat everything afterwards. And here it gives us the meaning that this eating would continue to be as long as they are in Jannah.
Okay. Allahu A'lam, some of the scholars have mentioned that here, the uskun here that is mentioned here, it refers to yani continue living in the Jannah. Yani they are already in the Jannah and continue living in the Jannah. So it's more about istiqrar, يعني to يعني stay in the Jannah. Stay in the Jannah, continue living in the Jannah, وَكُلَا مِنْهَا. As for the one in Al-A'raf, it refers to go into the Jannah and live in it. يعني they are, right now they're outside of Jannah, so it refers to يعني go into the Jannah and live in it. So once they enter the Jannah, then it will be said to them, فَكُلَا مِنْهَا رَغَدًا. حيث شئتما. هذا ذكره بعض العلماء. This is and it has been mentioned by some of the scholars. طيب. Okay, one more important question here. رغدا. أول شيء ما معنى رغدا? What is the meaning of رغدا?
Freely.
ها كيف? Freely. طيب freely and not just freely. يعني it is. It has a couple of meanings here. It has, يعني العيش, you can write this in Arabic, العيش الهني الواسع لا جهد فيه. العيش الهني الواسع الذي لا جهد فيه. The provision, لحظة, معلش. العيش الهني الواسع الذي لا جهد فيه. يعني, the provision, that is pleasant, abundant, and does not require effort to now it does not require effort to acquire it. It does not require effort to acquire it now. طيب العيش الهنيء الواسع الذي لا جهد فيه رغدا. طيب this is the meaning of رغد and this is here it's حال from the نعم it's حال from for Adam عليه السلام الله عالم or for the رزق that they're going to be eating. فكل منها رغدا. على كل in سورة الأعراف آية 19 do you find رغدا؟
No.
طيب why here رغدًا and there no رغدًا and had mentioned something at the beginning of the درس I told you to keep it in mind. Something at the start of the درس that we were supposed to keep in mind. This context, the context in which these ayat are being mentioned. Do you remember the context? إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةٌ وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَاءَ كُلَّهَا وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ. What is the context? The context is about it's honoring Adam عليه السلام, right? تكريم and إكرام for Adam عليه السلام. صح ولا ما هو صح؟
صح.
طيب. What is happening in Al-A'raf? In Al-A'raf, if you look at the context, it's more about warning us against the shaitan, right? يعني You go a few ayat forward and you'll find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us against the shaytan. يَا بَنِي آدَمَ لَا يَفْتِنَنَّكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ كَمَا أَخْرَجَ أَبَوَيْكُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ يَنْزِعُ عَنْهُمَا لِبَاسَهُمَا إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْآيَاتِ. There the context is about warning us from the shaytan and his deceptions. Here the context is more about Adam alayhi salam and how he is honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when the context is about honoring Adam alayhi salam, such a wasf is mentioned raghadan, yani al-aish al-hani al-wasi' alladhi la juhda fihi, yani eat from the jannah freely, which a risk that is pleasant, it's abundant, does not require effort. This is all from ikram and honoring for Adam alayhi salam. When it comes to that, so al-a'raf here, the objective Allahu alam is not yani not to express how Adam alayhi salam was honored, rather to relate to us the story and warn us against the shaitan that he should not be a cause for you to fall into fitna like he deceived your parents Adam alayhi salam and Hawa alayhi salam. Is that clear inshallah? وَكُلَا مِنْهَا رَغَدًا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمَا وَكُلَا مِنْهَا رَغَدًا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمَا وَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةَ. طيب قفوا هنا. Go to ayah number خلينا نشوف الرقم. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses Bani Israel in ayah 58 of Surah Al-Baqarah, page 9, he says, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا ادْخُلُوا هَذِهِ الْقَرْيَةَ فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا وَكُلَا مِنْهَا رَغَدًا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمَا فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا. Why has رَغَدًا been mentioned here before حَيْثُ شِئْتُمَا and over there with regards to Bani Israel it was mentioned after حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ يعني with the gospel of Islam after حيث شئتم فكلوا منها حيث شئتم رغدا. Ayah 58 of Surah Al-Baqarah, the ayah says فكلوا منها حيث شئتم رغدا. And هنا it says وكلا منها رغدا حيث شئتما ولا تقرب هذه الشجرة. طيب okay, what happens if you يعني في غير القرآن, if outside of Quran, if you try to put this after حيث شئتما, read the ayah وكلا منها حيث شئتما رغدا ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة. بنو إسرائيل أحسنت ممتاز جدا. Sister says that the Banu Israel weren't prohibited after they were given the permission to eat from everywhere. Here, there was a prohibition, right? So, حيث شئتما ولا تقربا, from everywhere you want, from wherever you want, but don't go near this شجرة. Don't go near this شجرة. So here it's more يعني both are related to each other. But when Banu Israel, when they were being addressed, it was said فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ رَغَدًا وَادْخُلُوا الْبَابَ سُجَّدًا. They weren't prohibited from any particular tree or any particular place within that area where they were allowed to eat from. So hence رَغَدًا could be mentioned after حَيْثُ شِئْتُمْ. But here رَغَدًا was mentioned before حَيْثُ شِئْتُمَا because they were also being prohibited from one shajara. And hence, now both of these are related, interrelated. حَيْثُ شِئْتُمَا everywhere, wherever you want, except for one shajara. Is that clear, inshallah?
نعم.
طيب ما هي هذه الشجرة التي نهي عنها؟ What is this tree that they were forbidden in the Jannah?
Can you go with that?
Allah. Bismillah. No one knows about it. Allahu a'lam. And is there much benefit in knowing what tree or what fruit it was?
No.
No, that's the point. Yani, you should learning tafsir, you should try to avoid things that are not of benefit. Yani, طيب. So that the purpose of the Quran is كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليتدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب أو ليتذكر أولو الألباب. To remember and to be reminded. And to learn from the Quran and gain piety. Such information is not of much use. طيب. ما الحكمة من النهي عن الشجرة? What is the wisdom behind forbidding Adam عليه السلام this شجرة, or forbidding this شجرة for Adam عليه السلام? What is the حكمة behind it? Test. أحسنتم. Test. ممتاز جدا. That's it. Test. No particular حكمة. يعني الله أعلم. Except that it's a test for Adam عليه السلام. طيب. نعم. الآن نأتي إلى لماذا قدم رغدا هنا وخير في قصة. لماذا جاء برغدا هنا ولم يذكر في الأعراف. هذا أيضا أخذنا. ما فائدة ولا تقربا بدل ولا تقربا. طيب. الله سبحانه وتعالى says here ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة. And he does not say ولا تأكلا من هذه الشجرة. What is the benefit that we gain from this? ولا تقرب هذه الشجرة. ولا تقرب هذه الشجرة.
ذريعة.
أسد الذرائع. Don't even go near it. سدوا الذرائع. This is a قاعدة عظيمة من قواعد الشرع. هذه قاعدة عظيمة من قواعد الشرع. This is a great fundamental from the fundamentals of the Sharia. The Sharia is pragmatic. It's practical. It prevents the means to evil as well. It does not just forbid you from evil. Rather, it also cuts off the means that lead to that evil. So it is easier for you to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obey Allah's commands. So it's easier for you to obey Allah's commands. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, مثلاً, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Don't go near zina. لا يقول وَلَا تَزْنُوا. Don't do zina. وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Don't go near it. You go near it, you might not be able to prevent yourself and save yourself from it, from the fitna. So don't go near the fitna. This is a qa'id azim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he subhanallah, look how he has cut the means that lead to zina. He has forbidden ikhtilat. He has commanded the rijal to the men to lower their gaze. He commanded the nisa as well to lower their gaze, even though the command for them is not as strict as it is for the men. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the women to observe hijab and niqab, right? All of these are preventive measures. These prevent zina. These prevent harassment. These prevent rapes. So subhanallah, yani al-sharia hakima. The sharia is full of wisdom. Sharia is full of wisdom. It does not just tell you what are the things you're not supposed to do. It does not just prohibit the intended things. Rather, it also cuts off the means that lead to it. Rather, it also cuts off the means that lead to it. And this is a great help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us. A great help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us. طيب ولا تقرب هذه الشجرة فتكون من الظالمين. طيب, on the other hand, we find people saying, Allah المستعان, oh, you guys force your women to wear hijab. Oh, this is so oppressive. You guys, you don't shake hands with women. Oh, this is so, sexist. And you guys don't do such and such things. And they are the very people who complain the most about sexual harassment. They are the people who complain the most about harassment. طبعاً, okay, there's another thing that must be kept in mind. That is that it's not necessary that if preventive measures are observed, the harm must be prevented. No, it just increases the probability of the harm being prevented, the main harm being prevented from occurring. Some people, they put forth this argument, and this is a fallacy. They say that, oh, but I know women who used to wear hijab, but they were still harassed. طيب يا أخي, don't you know people who lock their doors, but still have a theft occurring in their homes? They do. But locking your home increases your safety. Likewise, wearing hijab, lowering your gaze, increases your safety. It might not ensure your safety, but you have to increase the probability. That this is simple logic, yeah, simple hikmah, simple wisdom. But subhanallah, their hearts are diseased. Allahu al-musta'an. Same qa'ada is used for taghut. وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. Naam, stay away from taghut. Likewise, ikhwan, it's not just with regards to these sins, rather with regards to the fitan as well. Fitan in the deen, shubuhat. If there are doubts being casted, there are people, atheists, for example, they are casting doubts in the hearts of the Muslims. Don't listen to them. If you are weak, don't listen to them. Not because Islam is weak, because you are weak. Your knowledge of Islam is weak. Maybe you are not able to fight those doubts. It is as if you are. A very nice example is given when it said that a person who does not know how to swim, he can even drown in a pond, and the one who knows how to swim, he wouldn't even drown in a sea. So you are being prohibited and forbidden and told not to listen to the doubts and not to go near the fitan, not because Islam is not true or it's weak, rather because you don't know how to swim. First learn how to swim and then go and swim in the sea. You want to jump into the sea, dive into the sea while you don't know how to swim. Then if you perish, then this is your own fault. Allahu al-musta'an. طيب ولا تقرب هذه الشجرة فتكون من الظالمين. So else you will be from the ظالمين. طيب what is the difference فتكون من الظالمين between فتكون من الظالمين and to say فتظلم. And if ever said ولا تقرب هذه الشجرة فتظلم. And then you will have committed an act of oppression. And what is the difference between this and saying فتكون من الظالمين? يعني what is the difference between فَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةَ فَتَكُونَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ فَتَكُونَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ and to say فَتَظْلِمَ فَتَظْلِمَ يعني to then you will have committed an act of oppression. You will have committed ظلم. You will have committed an act of wrongdoing. طيب نعم
you'd be from the oppressors. This is Fema, and this Koda shows how deeply entrenched this person is in the in that particular thing that was forbidden from. As regards to just saying Fataslima, which perhaps just means you've just fallen into it once.
Mumtaz. Remember the difference between Jumla Ismiya and Jumla Fi'liya? Jumla Fi'liya tells us about some occurrence that occurred once. Jumla Ismiya indicates or denotes a continuous continuously being characterized with something. مثلا زيدٌ قائمٌ, he is continuously characterized as being in the standing position. But when you say قام زيدٌ, it means that Zayd has stood up once. Maybe now he's sitting, maybe he's in some other position. But when you say زيدٌ قائمٌ, that means he's continuously in the standing position. Likewise, إخوان هي فتكون من الظالمين. يعني أصله جملة اسمية صح؟ فتكون من الظالمين. Then you will be amongst the from amongst the ظالمين. This is يعني more intense in as a warning than to say فتظلم. Than to say فتظلم, that you would have committed an act of oppression. يعني when I'm trying to warn you against some معصية, some sin, then it would be, which one would be greater? But if I'd say, then you would have had made a mistake. If you do this, you will have committed a mistake. Or if I say, you will become from the group that commits lots of mistakes. The second one certainly is greater a warning than the first one. فَتَكُونَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. What is this fa here? What type of fa is it here? And what is this amal? What role does it play in the jumla in nahwi terms? In terms of nahu.
Fa-sababiyya.
طيب, fa-sababiyya, ماذا تعمل? What does it do to the fi'l mudari?
Makes it mansoob.
Mansoob. طيب, is fatakuna here mansoob?
طيب.
طيب, what is the alama of nasb here? الآن
الفتحة.
لا, ما في فتحة. لا, ما هي فتحة. ألف فتكون ألف, لا خطأ. ألف هذا فاعل. ألف هذه فاعل. طيب المضارع هذا فعل مضارع. This one. Is it صحيح الآخر, معتل الآخر, أو من الأفعال الخمسة؟
ممكن أفعال الخمسة.
من الأفعال الخمسة. إذن ما علامة النصب؟
حذف النون.
أحسنت. طيب. The fa al-sababiyya must be preceded by نفي or طلب. Is there any نفي or طلب here? نفي or نهي, طلب.
لا. ولا تقرب.
نعم, ولا تقرب. This is نهي. This is طلب. نهي. ولا تقرب. And do not. So this is why the fa here made the فعل منصوب. طيب. Something to reflect on. Something to ponder about. What is the يعني ratio in proportion ratio between the things that are halal that were permitted for Adam alayhi salam to what was made impermissible, and the whole of Jannah was made permissible for Adam alayhi salam except for one shajara, but Shaytan makes sure that he causes Adam alayhi salam to eat from that shajara and deceive him into eating from that shajara. Likewise is the case, ya ikhwan, in the dunya. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made something haram, he makes yani many times of those haram things, yani there are several substitutes for those things that Allah has made haram. Allah made zina haram, Allah has made yani marriage halal. Allah has made khamr haram, Allah has made yani thousands of types of drinks halal for us. It's just that the shaitan makes you feel, oh, it's so difficult. Oh, everything in Islam is haram. Ya akhi, everything is halal. Only a very few things are haram. So keep this in mind. Whenever you are about to commit something haram, ya ikhwan, just think about it. Think about it. How many things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made halal for you? How big a favorite of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is this? And how you should be thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for making so many things permissible for you. So why not choose from something that is permissible than committing that which is haram? طيب ناتي الآن إلى الآية التالية. فأزلهما الشيطان عنها فأخرجهما مما كان فيه. فأزلهما ما معنى فأزل أو أزل يعني؟
Cause them to sleep.
Cause them to sleep. Ahsan. Cause them to sleep. Yani when you use the ta'bir azallahuma, yani when you use the ta'bir of slipping, yani as if they were caught off guard. Yani shaitan yani exploited their innocence, huh? Fa azallahuma ash-shaytanu anha. طيب عن ماذا أزلهما؟ عنها عن what? From what? From what? عنها عن ماذا؟
Staying away from the tree.
From the tree. فأزلهما الشيطان عنها. From the tree. From the جنة. أحسنت. From the جنة. فأزلهما الشيطان عن الجنة. طبعا there are two calls here, but the more correct one seems to be that عنها يعني عن الجنة. Okay. أزل means to cause someone to fall into a زلل. To cause someone to slip. طيب. عنها يعني is this preposition, is this جار and مجرور suitable with أزل here or does it indicate something else? يعني أزلهم الشيطان alone is enough that شيطان caused them to fall into a خطأ, caused them to fall into زلل فأخرجهما مما كان فيه. But when it's along with أزلهما, it's used, يعني Allah subhanahu used إجار المجرور عنها, from the Jannah. طيب, cause them to fall into زلل, يعني cause them to slip, cause them to fall into a mistake from Jannah. And does it, يعني if you يعني take it on face value, does it make sense or there must be something hidden here? From the order of Allah, the order of Allah, لا. From عنها من الجنة, يعني عن الجنة. Remember, do you remember? ونحن نسبح بحمدك ونقدس لك. Remember ونقدس لك. طيب, what was there? What was the secret behind ونقدس لك?
تضمين.
تضمين. What is تضمين? Tazmeen is to embed into one fi'l, another fi'l, and indicate its existence by using a preposition that is suitable for that fi'l. Yani an easy example of this is, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, yani, أَلَا إِنَّ عَادًا كَفَرُوا رَبَّهُمْ مَثَلًا. طيب. كَفَرَ usually comes along with ba, right? كفر بآياتنا كفر بكذا كفر بالله, right? Here it came without ba. كفروا ربهم. So it يعني the meaning of كذب was embedded into كفر. That's why it did not use the preposition ba. Okay, we have another example. ونحن نسبح بحمدك ونقدس لك. نقدس يعني we say يعني we glorify you, O Lord. طيب ونقدسك, we glorify you. Why نقدس لك? Because there is another fi'l here that is embedded within نقدس, and the indication to it is given by the lamb that is used laka. طيب, so what is that fi'l that is suitable here that we could any imagine? وَنُقَدِّسُكَ وَنَنْقَادُ لَكَ, and we comply with your commands and we obey your commands. فَأَزَلَّهُمَ الشَّيْطَانُ عَنْهَا, فَأَزَلَّهُمَ الشَّيْطَانُ is enough, يعني he caused them to slip and caused them to commit a mistake. عَنْهَا, يعني فَأَزَلَّهُمَ الشَّيْطَانُ وَنَحَّاهُمَا عَنْهَا, and he caused them to leave the Jannah, caused them to go away from the Jannah, caused them to become far away from the Jannah. عرفتم? So there is a hidden embedded fi'l within فَأَزَلَّهُمَ الشَّيْطَانُ عَنْهَا, and how do we know about it? We know about it through عَنْهَا, يعني, because if only أَزَلَّهُمَا is intended, then عَنْهَا would not be used. But عَنْهَا when it's used, then we know that there is another fi'l here for which an ishara has been given. طيب. فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِمَّا كَانَا فِيهِ, فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِمَّا كَانَا فِيهِ. طيب. Allah, and he caused them to exit what they were in. What is the meaning of mimma kana fi? Yani what were they in? Mimma kana fi, kana fi al-jannah. But jannah has already been mentioned here. Anha fa akhrajahuma mimma kana fi. So what is it referring to here? The blessings, Ahsan, the blissful state that they were in. فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِمَّا كَانَ فِيهِ, فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِنَ الْحَالِ الَّتِي كَانَ فِيهَا, مِنَ الْحَالِ الْعَظِيمِ, مِنَ النَّعِيمِ الَّذِي كَانَ فِيهِ. And that's why اسم موصول here is used in order to indicate the greatness of the conditions and the state that they were in order to indicate the greatness and the blissfulness of the state that they were in. فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِنَ النَّعِيمِ الَّذِي كَانَ كان فيه. طبعا ما هي is موصولة. Okay. Wasn't Iblis mentioned just a couple of ayahs ago? إلا إبليس أبا واستكبر وكان من الكافرين. طيب. فأزلهما الشيطان. ليش الشيطان هنا؟ لماذا لم يقال إبليس؟ فأزلهما إبليس. Why was Iblis used there and not شيطان? And why is your شيطان used here and not Iblis?
Name here suits the context.
طيب, what is the relation between the context and the usage of shaytan here and their Iblis and the context? And what is the relation between the two? Okay, what is Iblis? What is the purpose of excluding Iblis there? Yani the purpose is to point out the person Iblis, right? Illa Iblis, yani fasajada, yani adkhul al-malaikatu tasjudu li adama fasajadu illa Iblis. So there the purpose was to point out the person of Iblis, right? Here his characteristic is being mentioned because here he caused someone to deviate from the right path. So his characteristic, his most prominent attribute is being mentioned, but that is shaytan. What is the meaning of shaytan? Someone who is
far from all goodness.
Far from all goodness. Shaytan deceives. Ahsantum. Mumtaz jiddan. فَأَزَلَّهُمَ الشَّيْطَانِ. Why shaytan here? Because he's far from goodness. So when he's deceiving someone and causing him to deviate from the right path, then the shaytan is more suitable to be used in order to refer to Iblis. Over there, وَيَقُلَ لِمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ. The person of Iblis was intended, so the word he was referred to by his name. فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِمَّا كَانَ فِيهِ وَقُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌّ. وَقُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا, and لَيْسَ فَقُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا. Why? وَقُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا وَلَيْسَ فَقُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا. This one is easy, inshallah. What is the meaning of fa means then, right? And it gives you the meaning that it's a particular thing happened after the previous one. This statement take place after the previous one. فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا مِمَّا كَانَ فِي, فَأَخْرَجَهُمَا, خلاص, it's referring to the same same story. يعني فأخرجهما, he caused them to go out of Jannah. How or what, how did it happen? How did they exit the Jannah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, وَقُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌّ قُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا. So that's why wow here was more suitable. If fa was used, it would have meant that shaitan caused him to exit Jannah, and then Allah said, يعني descend from the Jannah. ما تجي هذه. يعني they have already been expelled from the Jannah because of the shaitan. So how would Allah, after expelling them from the Jannah, say, قُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا. So that's why the wow is being used, because this is a sentence that is explanatory for the previous one. فَقُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٍ. Some of you are enemies for, يعني you are enemies to each other. بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٍ. You are enemies to each other. Who is enemy to whom? Type, you're saying humans. Type, before you say humans, type, ihbitu. Who are being addressed here? Ihbitu. Who are the people being addressed here? Ihbitu. Descend.
We don't have to catch it. So we have. Let's break down the middle.
Sorry, again, yeah, Uthman. Adam alayhi salam and Adam al-Hawa. Type, what about the one? What about Iblis? Iblis is also being addressed. قَالَهْ وَقُلْنَهْ بِطُوهُ. All of you three. طيب بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ قَوْلًا لِلْعُلَمَ. بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ. Some say that it means that the children of Adam, they themselves are يعني, enemies to each other because of their أعمال. And some say that here it refers to the shaitan being the عدو for Adam عليه السلام and his progeny. So this is more likely, wallahu a'lam, because Allah subhanahu says in the Quran, inna shaytana lakum aduwwun fattakhidhuhu aduwwa. Indeed, the shaytan is an enemy to you, so take him as an enemy, consider him as an enemy. Ba'dukum li ba'din aduw. In this we have a great, Allah subhanahu is warning this, the shaytan, he's saying that he is an enemy to you, so take him as an enemy, treat him like an enemy, and beware him like an enemy. Allah subhanahu warns us every time, but Allah subhanahu still yani fall into the deceptions, fall for the traps of shaitan. Likewise, we fall, just like we fall for the traps of Yahud and Nasara. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول وَلَن تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَن نَصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعْ مِلَّتَهُمْ. طيب, the Yahud and Nasara will never be pleased with you until you follow their millah, their religion. صح? But we still listen to the Yahud and Nasara, and يعني, we are trying to please them and watering down our religion just to please them, Allah al-Musta'an. Yani because perhaps we don't really believe in the Quran the way we should. قُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ. طيب, what is the meaning of هَبَطَ يَهْبِطُوا? اهْبِطُوا, اهْبِطُوا, هَبَطَ يَهْبِطُوا. It means descend, right? طيب, but what is the difference between اهْبِطُوا and انزلوا, مثلا? In الاستعمال القرآن, يعني in the Quranic usage of اهْبِطُوا and انزلوا. In أنزلنا, and اهبطوا, yeah, looking at the usage of these two words, اهبطوا is morely used when it is يعني, when there is a sense of any punishment, sense of retribution for some evil or for some sins. طيب, شيطان is being addressed. فاهبط منها فما يكون لك أن تتكبر فيها. Likewise, Adam عليه السلام, Iblis and Hawa are being addressed, saying اهبطوا بعضكم لبعض عدو. وهكذا. As for أنزلنا, it has more يعني more honor to it. يعني the Quran, it's not said أهبطنا القرآن, لا, it says وأنزلنا القرآن. So نزول has more honor, it's more يعني in terms when it is يعني used in the sense of more respectful sense. إهبط is more in يعني the sense of retribution for some bad deeds. طيب, اهبطوا بعضكم لبعض عدو ولكم في الأرض مستقر. What is the meaning of مستقر? مستقر. What is this noun? This is اسم ما. هاي يا شباب, اسم ماذا? هل هذا اسم مفعول ولا اسم مكان ولا اسم زمان؟ يلا بسم الله. اسم مفعول مكان أو زمان؟
مفعول.
لا لا خطأ. هنا it's اسم مكان. ولكم في الأرض مستقر. Place of residence. Place where you can reside and you can reside. ومتاع إلى حين and a provision for you until a particular time. إلى حين. طيب why حين and why not إلى الحين؟ A particular time for everyone. يعني it's a particular time that is unknown to you. That is unknown to you. متاع provision. متاع is everything that يعني a person needs in this life. متاع has been derived from متاع يعني ميم تاعين, which means to enjoy something. So متاع is all the stuff, all the provision that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala has given us that we enjoy and benefit from. طيب quickly inshallah before the maghrib adhan goes on. ومغرب برستاس. فتلقى آدم من ربه كلمات فتاب عليه إنه هو التواب الرحيم. قبل لحظة اهبطوا هنا. In سورة طه it says اهبطا. Why in سورة طه it says اهبطا, here it says اهبطوا? Because here Allah سبحانه وتعالى is يعني referring to both آدم and حواء together. In سورة طه the whole context was for آدم عليه السلام alone. فعصى آدم ربه فغوى ثم اجتباه ربه فتاب عليه وهدى. طيب so when it was only Adam عليه السلام, حواء was تابعة for Adam عليه السلام. يعني the mention of حواء goes along with Adam عليه السلام. That's why اهبطا with the صيغة for مثنى, صيغة for مثنى, because it's referring to Adam and شيطان only, right? And حواء is along with Adam عليه السلام in سورة طه. Here in Surah Al-Baqarah, Hawa is being mentioned separately. So that's why اهبطوا, يعني three of you. طيب. Quickly moving on. سامحوني, like I have to just a little, had to يعني just speed up a little. فتلقى آدم من ربه كلمات فتاب عليه إنه هو التواب الرحيم. فتلقى آدم. طيب. Before that, فأزلهما الشيطان عنها. فأخرجهما مما كانا فيه. But here only Adam. Why?
Because he is the prophet.
Ahsan, because he is the prophet. He is the one who will receive revelation and be inspired by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. فتلقى آدم من ربه. What are these words that were inspired to Adam عليه السلام?
The dua, the ربنا ظلمنا
أنفسنا. Ahsan, ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا ولم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكون من الخاسرين. Why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what does he refer to himself by using the word Rabbihi, min Rabbihi, instead of فَتَلَقَّ آدَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ? فَتَلَقَّ آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ. This one is easy.
Yeah, because Rabb has those other meanings, like the sustainer, the...
Rabb, تربية رباه, يعني he nurtures and he takes care of Adam عليه السلام. It gives you the sense of closeness. يعني فتلقى آدم من ربه, it gives you it alludes to the rahmah, the mercy of Allah, the divine care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Adam عليه السلام. So which necessitated that Adam عليه السلام was inspired these ad'iya from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the word Rabb was used here. طيب فتاب عليه, ما معنى فتاب عليه؟ تاب عليه باخذ ترى ثقيل. فتاب عليه
is repentance.
Mada, his repentance, what?
Allah accepted his repentance.
Ahsan, taba alayhi, to accept repentance. Taba ilayhi, to repent to Allah. Taba ilallah, fataba Allahu alayhi. Taba alayhi is used to express the acceptance of repentance. Taba ilallahi, ila is used to express the repentance of a person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب تاب عليه, he accepted his repentance. إنه هو التواب الرحيم. What is, how many مؤكدات are used when إنه هو التواب الرحيم? How many articles of emphasis? إنه هو التواب الرحيم.
Three.
تقريبا yes. إنه هو التواب الرحيم. طيب إنه إن then هو the, again the ضمير is mentioned in order to add emphasis that this ضمير is called ضمير الفصل. It's repeated. We already have who. إنه. We already have the ضمير that refers to the third person. But we, the ضمير is repented. It's repeated in order to add emphasis. إنه هو التواب الرحيم. He alone, as if he alone is التواب الرحيم. What is the meaning of التواب? التواب. What is the difference between التائب or قابل التوب and التواب? التواب.
The one who often accepts.
Ahsan, the one who often accepts the tawbah, not just accepts the tawbah, yani rather often accepts the tawbah. A lot of times accepts the tawbah because tawab is siga mubalagha, faal, siga mubalagha. It's on the scale of faal, siga mubalagha. This is called faal. طيب, إنه هو التواب الرحيم. الرحيم is صفة مشبهة as or صيغة مبالغة depending on how it's being used. Likewise, it means any most merciful. إنه هو التواب الرحيم. What do we benefit from the end part of this ayah? We benefit from the end part of this ayah, which is general, that all listeners, the ones who are listening to the story, who are reading the Quran, remember you yourselves as well that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, He Himself is التواب الرحيم. No one else is التواب الرحيم. So you also, just like Adam alayhi salam repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not delay your repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not delay your repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ. He was soon inspired words, and Adam alayhi salam repented instantly, and he hasted to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Likewise, يا إخوان, نحن كذلك ينبغي علينا أن نتوب إلى الله عز وجل فورا. We should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the soonest, the earliest. نسأل الله أن ينفعنا بما علمنا ونكتفي بهذا القدر. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. If anyone has any question, he can ask quickly, 1 minute.